I am 21 years old. I am the youngest of 13 children. Two of my eight brothers are internationally famous athletes, Maurice Mad Dog Vachon and Paul the Butcher Vachon. My name is Vivian. I also wrestle.
Tell me, how does it feel to be a wrestling queen? Sometimes the crowd loves you, then the lowdown and mean. Like down in Louisiana, after a show, you left with tears in your eyes and blood on your clothes. How it goes. That old crowd's getting angry and happy inside about things that it don't understand. You got flowers on Sunday and walks in the park. It sure feels like a real winning hand. Then you hear that your lover's gonna go to Australia and your heart sinks because it's so far.
Now we're a little over 2 years, but anyway, she wins a little more, I guess, than she loses. She, you know, she didn't know what she was going to do, but she also liked to travel. She wanted to see the world. Morris says, okay, we'll show you wrestling, and he says, you got to build for it, but she says, you got to win every time. That's Morris's idea. For his Dominion Championship, he was 17 years old in Athabasca, Alberta. And he won it for 5 years in succession till he turned professional. In 1948, he went to the Olympics and he came in fourth in his class, 167 pounds. In 1950, he went to Auckland, New Zealand, to the British Empire Games, and he won that. So I'm kind of proud of him. He's the smallest of the family, but he makes all right. How it started? He ran away from home. He was 13 years old, and he got picked up by the police. He was about 100 miles east of Montreal, and police asked him, where are you going? He says, we want to go out west for the crops. It was in October. They were dressed in low shoes. So I went over to get him in the police station. I says, what's the matter with you? Well, he says, I don't want to go to school. I want to travel. Well, I says, you should learn wrestling. He says, you'll travel all over the world. He says, okay. So I put the three of them in the YMCA. I says, you'll learn English. It'll give you a chance to earn your living much easier if you know both languages. I says, you go all over the world, everybody speaks English. And he did, and he never stopped.
Yes, I was a wrestler in the 1948 Olympics. I didn't win a gold medal there, but I'm very proud of the fact that I beat the champion of India in 53 seconds.
Really?
Yes, and at the time I was 18 years old, and I'm very proud of the fact that I've taken part in the Olympics. It's helped me a great deal in my professional career. I started with a basic wrestling, and now I'm a professional wrestler. And it's very, very tough. Just the traveling alone can kill the average person.
Get the name Mad Dog?
Well, I'll tell you. It happened in, it was a funny situation. It happened in Portland, Oregon. It was my first time in the state of Oregon, and I didn't know the rules, too many rules at the time about wrestling and professionally in that state. And before the bell rang, I jumped in across the ring and I attacked my opponent and I knocked him down, and the referee tried to stop me, and I knocked him down, threw him out of the ring. Then the police came in the ring, where there was a policeman over there, came in the ring and tried to stop me, and I threw him out of the ring, and I gave him a body slam outside the ring, and I got disqualified right there and then. Besides that, I got suspended for 2 months. And Don Owens was the promoter in Portland, Oregon, said, "You look just like a mad dog in the ring." So I guess that's where I got the name Mad Dog.
Look at, or you know, anything.
Yes. When you see your opponent down and bleeding and begging for mercy, that's the way I like it. That's what's beautiful. Because I've been down before, but I've never been out. And when they're down and they're suffering and they're getting beat up, that's what I like. I got scars. I have so many scars now I can't even count. I must have got thousands. Right over here, there was 23 stitches in this one. That was when I was wrestling Crusher Nozawski in Minneapolis on television. Well, by the time they got me to the hospital, I had almost lost all my blood. But luckily, the doctor told me afterward, he says, "Mad Dog, most athletes have 1 quart of blood more than the average person. That's nature's way of paying back somebody that keeps trim." And I was very thankful that night I had 1 quart of blood more than the average person. I'll guarantee you that.
I've been 20 years, professional wrestling 20 years now. So I've got a lot of years of experience, and some of the opponents that I have in the ring, rings only have a few years. So they're stumbling around that ring, and I'm already thinking ahead of them. I know what I'm going to do, where I'm going to go, and what moves I'm going to make. So I have the advantage over that. The experience counts a lot in professional wrestling. If you can get the advantage over your opponent and keep that advantage now, just because I get my advantage over my opponent, I'm not going to fall back and say, well, you go ahead until you do your little bit. No way. I'm going to that ring, take the first opportunity I can, take advantage of it, and keep on my opponent. Just keep on, keep on, keep on, until the final referee makes me break it, because I don't really shake hands or anything like that. In fact, if my opponent sticks out of hand, I'm going to poke him in the eye or something like that. In fact, if he gets down there, I'm not the type of person that's going to step back and say, well, stand up. I like to fight my men standing up. No way. If he gets down there, I'm going to put my boots to him. I'm going to kick him, and I'm going to keep him down there. So I'm not really a bad wrestler. I'm just a smart wrestler. But the match I'm about to go in the ring for, I figured that's going to be my toughest match.
I'm Paul Butcher, Vachon, Vivian's other brother. I'm going to throw a party tonight after the matches. Vivian is going to the States on a tour. And having been a wrestler myself for 18 years and now the promoter and general manager in Montreal for Grand Prix Wrestling, I know how much traveling she's going to be doing. We're going to get together and give her a farewell party. I invited some of the boys, their wives and girlfriends. We're going to the beer garden. And we're going to have a good time and make sure we send her off on the right foot.
Thank you. this particular program, which is put out every week. I enjoy doing it. I have my wife also. I like to bring my wife into it. She's a big help to me. My wife, Ethel. And we have quite a job on us. I have one other fella that's program sales in Houma, Louisiana, that helps us out in the sales also.
Miss Dawn Putnam, I have five reserves. Five on it's Putnam.
My brothers did, Paul and Maurice, Mad Dog Vachon and Butch Vachon. Well, you know, after you've been in the business 20 years, if you don't have some kind of pull in any kind of business, you might as well be out of it. But they've got a good name and good reputation, so naturally they took a chance, you know, by giving me a few breaks when I started.
You telling me how to referee? You just thrash. Don't worry about my referee.
Why do fans like women wrestlers? Well, it's something that there aren't very many women that wrestle in the first place, and it's something original and it's something new for them to go see. And besides, men love women, right? And they get a kick out of it, I think. You know, just watching the women wrestle. I don't know what they do. They might just sit there and have dreams about us, or I don't know. Whatever they do, it's good for them, right? If they're coming to the matches.
Yeah! a ball here, and it's a good, clean sport. And I like the tag team matches best. And I get excited. I'm about like Mary. I want to jump up in the ring, too.
like it. I wish that more people would come to it, and I wish that we could participate more, and I wish we could fight sometime.
I mean, all of them jumping in there together and everything makes everybody so exciting. They jump up and down, and most fun is watching the people, too.
I think it's a great sport.
It's kind of, I don't know, the way they throw them off the ring and everything, it's just dangerous, I guess.
It's because I enjoy it. See the fighting and roughness. And I would come every Monday night if I had a way to come.
Oh, he's great.
We're pretty good guy.
Loser, Hodge!
You're a loser!
Come on, Charlie.
No, not as long as it's a good wrestler match. I don't have no favorite. Lebo McGirt used to be my man. He was my man.
Oh, yeah?
In fact, it's my grandson is named after Lebo.
Wrestling has been so kind to me that I put my whole life into it. And, of course, after I lost my sight, it was a wonderful thing that I could keep on and do real well and be one of the foremost promoters in the country despite the fact that I was blind. Something electric about a good professional wrestler. I mean, a real talk. There's professional wrestling, there's professional wrestling. There's something about a real talk professional wrestler, a fellow that is capable of attracting tremendous crowds or girls that capable of doing the same thing. When they walk into the ring, they climb into the ring and get in there and take their robe off and waiting for the match to start. You don't have to see the match start to find out that there's just something that communicates itself with that person to the crowd. It's just something, as I said, electric.
Bill Watts, best of all, and Danny Hodge. We like it. We don't do anything else but come here to wrestling, and we don't go honky-tonk. We may not want that.
Hey! Ages of the women that sit in the front row, anywhere from 40 to 70. You know why they go there?
Why?
Not to see the wrestling match. They want to see those big fellas, you know what I mean?
No, tell me.
Well, I don't like to say that, but they're so physical, and they just peek and look. They don't care if they kill each other. They just want to see what they can see.
I like baseball and football better.
How about you,
I'd like to beg the question.
To like any kind of sports, boxing, wrestling, horse races, football, baseball, basketball, anything. Why do we like it? It's another sport.
If you had to sum up what your opinion of wrestling is in one sentence, what would you say? I said a bunch of shit, as far as I'm concerned.
Well, I like how the big, strong guys pick up the other guys and then throw them on the ground.
Who's your favorite?
His name is Grizzly Smith.
Why do you like him?
Well, he's nice. He talks, you know, kind of nice.
I think one of the things that has helped me to understand life and to enjoy life as much as I do is my father. There was a man that really knew how to mold a person. And he molded me. He did it in the right way. He did it down in the harness shed. There was a man that he would give you a whipping for lying to him. He'd give you a whipping whenever he thought you needed it. He'd give you a whipping for making a mistake. And believe me, I made my share of mistakes. I got kicked through the wall of a barn by a mule. And that was one of the hardest whippings that I ever got. My father took the time to explain to me that he wasn't whipping me for trying to break the mule from kicking, which I did. After I got kicked through the wall of the barn, I took an axe handle to the mule and decided I was going to break the mule from kicking. That's when I got caught. But he took the time to explain to me that he wasn't breaking or wasn't whipping me for trying to break that mule from kicking. What he gave me the whipping for was for walking behind a mule in the first place. This is why I say that the man molded me and showed me how to enjoy life.
Yeah, I hope it's good.
Are you excited?
Yeah. Now I'm excited.
Oh, yeah? What would you say if you had to describe wrestling in one sentence? How you feel about wrestling?
It's fun to watch, and it's funny, because all the guys get flying all around.
Dale Woods.
What do you do?
I don't like his style.
What does he do?
He's kind of vicious. He'd get down kind of nasty with his wrestling. He don't stick to the rules at all.
Yeah.
wife might give a fellow a lot of trouble at home, and he comes down to the wrestling mat, that husband, and he can give vent to his anger that maybe he can't strangle the wife or something like that, but he can sit there and raise the devil and yell at somebody that's in the ring, and he also can see some action, and he lets off a lot of steam and pent up reserves that he needs to give a valve to let it off. And I think wrestling is wrestling does that for a number of fans. Who goes to wrestling? Everybody goes to wrestling. The people who go to wrestling that like a rough. The wrestling has developed into more of a rough sport than it used to be, and you find that a lot of people like roughness, and they like this sort of thing. I don't know why it is. In the old days when wrestling was strictly a scientific contest, and they didn't allow the punching, or they're not supposed to allow the punching now, but they rather than stop a match when it just gets started and throw them out of the ring, the referee knows that these people came to see something, and he doesn't dare do that. So consequently, that's why a lot of these rough fellas get away with it. They like to see roughness, they like to see action and excitement. We have the excitement is there because numerous occasions older people come to our matches, and we've had so many heart attacks that I feel that a lot of them should have had an examination before they come, but they want to see that sort of thing. I guess that's the explanation that I could have. It isn't some of them like the scientific aspect of it, but I suspect that a great many of them like the rough and tumble action.
They follow them all over.
I
wouldn't be surprised if some of the wrestlers are humping them.
You get used to the punishment, the daily, day in and day out torture, match after match, stitch after stitch.
The best ones missing. As the rest of them are on ship, cut in two and broken in two, broken in half.
I had almost every bone in my body broken. And you have a lot of time to think of it, but you get the feeling, the beautiful feeling of slamming someone against the mat, bending on their arms, crushing and bending, and I've rode Brammer Bulls 2,000 pounds, and nothing is like the feeling of picking someone over your head and slamming them to the mat.
and punching and elbow smashes and headlocks from most every professional wrestler that's been wrestling for two or three years. We all got cauliflower ears. I guess this is our trademark.
Wrestling is one of the most fabulous feelings in the world. The actual feeling of bending and being slammed and being hit and stomped is fantastic.
Those people out there that are hollering and yelling for you, they're going to be yelling against you because they love a winner. And this country is built on winning, winning, winning. Professional wrestling is winning and losing. Now, if you lose three, four times in a row, see how many times you're going to be on the main event. See how many times you're going to be on top. You can take any wrestler, and if he loses, he eats hamburgers. If he wins, he eats the big steaks.
It gets pretty rough down here in the South. There's a lot of contenders for the North American Heavyweight Championship, and the majority of them are pretty rough wrestlers. Side of the good guy or don't like the bad guy, you know, and they kind of get with each other and decide to get on the wrestler. A lot of times there you'll see them run up there and try to hit the wrestler or beat on the canvas or something like that.
I was attacked from in the back by a fan, stabbed in the back, stabbed in the leg, refusing 200 stitches, making it to the hospital just in time to save my life.
You know, they really get wild. They really do. I've had a few jump on them and tear my suit off and stuff like that. So that's really what we do.
Come on, you! Take a swing, anyone! Come on! Don't stand there, you punk! Get out of my way!
No, sir, just very, very few serious problems that we have. We, like I said, we got enough of us here. We also got civil defense men that work the balcony, upstairs. They keep down the people, keep people throwing things.
That's what makes you nervous. You don't know where the things might come from. Sometimes they have apples with razor blades in them, sometimes with nails. They threw that at you in the ring.
I've seen everything thrown from Coke bottles to snuff. They get to throwing them, they don't care what they throw. Umbrellas, pop bottles. Got to where we wouldn't even let anybody go in with pop bottles.
Walk with him, get under there!
Let me tell you something, you four-eyed little freak, you. Take your old man and go on home.
You shut up, you son of a bitch!
Go on home and milk your cows.
It gets rough sometimes, but you keep on and you keep on plugging, and you get to actually like the pain and the glory and the roar of the crowd.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, I think the war is over, I hope.
I personally come from a family of wrestlers. You know, my brother Mad Dog was in the business before me. But nowadays we get wrestlers from all different walks of life. Used to be that it was more or less like boxing. You know, if you had a hard life when you were young and you had to fight for everything, it was a field to go into where you didn't really need a big education to make a success. All you needed was determination or size or strength. Nowadays, in professional wrestling, I think probably 90% of the professional wrestlers today have a college degree.
Wrestling is the most natural sport of all. Most people know, most people maybe don't know. Wrestling is the second oldest sport on earth.
Well, I think it's here to stay.
You got to know how to do it to do it.
Yeah, I've seen wrestling on TV, and I like it, and I get pretty interested in it, but I've never been to one.
Do you think it's real, or do you think it's fake?
What do you mean, when they're bleeding? Is it fake?
Or just the whole match?
No, I think it's just as real to life as I am.
It's a bunch of shit.
Wrestling, the people want a winner, and don't forget, the losers, you forget about, people forget about them right away, and they remember the winners. And it's money that talks, you're there for the money, and everybody's out there to cut your throat, to win, 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 so they keep on being on top, being in the main events, and making the money. That's the name of the game. Let's not kid ourselves. It's professional sports, and the money is what matters. Number one, to win and to get the money.
This is what it's all about. Wrestling is what's happening as far as I'm concerned.
Well, I think it's all a fake.
But did you enjoy it?
Oh, I enjoyed it.
What part of it do you think is fake?
Well, it's just fake. There's no blood there.
I'll go and pay money to see a woman wrestle, but I ain't going to pay no money to see a bunch of guys throw themselves around the ring.
The reason they come to the matches is because, you know, they get thrills out of it. All kinds of thrills, you know. And nobody has ever sat down and told me what they felt, but I've seen some pretty weird things, you know.
But if you dig it, it's fine. You know, it's cool. Everybody has their own bag. It's personal. Tell us yours.
I wouldn't go in the toilet with one of them, I'll tell you that.
Don't care too much for it.
Well, I think the more I
stay in wrestling, the more I have to keep my body in shape, and so I exercise so much more than the normal person would. And I think for this reason, the more I wrestle, the more beautiful I become.
How about the women?
Oh, wow. Women. that's really just too much.
It's something a man would enjoy more, you know.
Leo, this this match with the girl here, we have this Vivian Vachon for New Orleans. Who would you suggest? You know, Vivian is exciting and fast and colorful and moves with a great deal of speed.
From Montreal, Canada, weighing 155 pounds, here is Vivian Vachon.
This Marie Laverne. She's very active, and I think she'll give her quite a run for her money there.
Ann Laverne's daughter, yes. Marie Laverne, yes, I remember her.
Ladies and gentlemen, from France, weighing 139 pounds, Sidi Laverne. 30-minute timer.
Sidi Laverne, what a name. If I had a name like that, I'd sleep all night.
My mother is the Texas champion, and I hope she keeps the belt. And once my grandmother and my grandfather were the mixed tag team champions. And some people say that wrestling's fake, and I don't think so, because my mother has sores all over and mat burns, and it looks like it really hurts when people think it's really fake. The wrestlers, the girl wrestlers, are very beautiful. Except I think my mother's the beautifulest one that there is.
How about women wrestlers? Have you ever seen them?
I saw them once. Oh, did that turn me off? On.
She's cute. She's no good. And the other one's the best.